anybody wants to come up, you're welcome. But you'll be like a model in my video. But it's not like
a sermon.
Yeah, I do everything perfect. Not really, but.
Super easy, but you gotta lift your leg up one at a time without like leaning back. Man. Working on the quads. Any requests for today for our practice on our mat? Any requests? Who do not know me, and this is my friend D, or Demetrius Thomas. He's going to offer some therapeutic sounds for you during your practice today, so I hope you enjoy. We'll begin in a comfortable seated position, just starting to ground down into our practice. Invitation to close the eyes if that feels comfortable for you today. Knowing that this doesn't always have to feel comfortable. Closing the eyes felt good yesterday, and today you're not quite feeling it, or vice versa. So just honoring wherever you are in your practice today. Same goes for the movements, the forms. Whatever you choose, I invite you to take a moment to just scan through the body, noticing where there's any tension, if at all, just scanning through the crown of the head, the face, seeing if you can soften a bit more in the eyebrows, eyelids, the jaw. Elevate your hips. You don't have to carry that unnecessary tension in your practice. We have tools to assist us. Together for all. knee and planting that left palm behind the body for a spinal twist here. Gazing over that left shoulder. Expanding through the collarbones and pressing the shoulders away from the ears. Maybe with each inhale here, you find more length along the spine as you draw the crown of your head upward. And as you exhale, twisting deeper into this form, finding your edge here and honoring that your edge may not be the same as your neighbor's, and that's okay.
Shoulders over the wrists. If you kind of look from your wrists to knees, they should be
of the elbow here or arm here. So what that looks like, a lot of inner eyes of the elbows are facing inward. Without moving the hands, because we're going to continue pressing firmly into the ground, we're just going to turn them forward. So from here, turn them forward and keeping that gentle bend in the elbows. Beautiful adjustment, everyone. From here, we'll inhale into a cow form. So lowering the belly down to the mat, sending the gaze and tailbone up.
Child's pose, sending the hips towards the heels.
clap for one more round. Last one of our floating table. So making your way into the form at your own pace. We'll all be there together.
Opening up the hip here, maybe making some circles. If you're
up at hip, gazing underneath that right armpit. Next inhale, lengthen, extend it up like nice and long. As you exhale, we're gonna step that foot in between the palms, coming into a runner's lunge. Yeah, the blocks, if the hips are still a bit tight, you can use your blocks. There's three levels, so you have this wide flat surface. We have level two, which is the wide narrow, and then the tall narrow. So if you would like to create some space for yourself here, you can use the blocks to do so.
Forward.
left hip. So you may want to consciously draw that left hip back and down and the right hip forward. They're squared forward. Good. Turn this toe a little bit more forward, just a little bit. Thank you.
right foot is closer to the right edge of your mat, so you have a more center of balance here. And we're going to square the hips forward so that right hip comes down and back. Left hip forward, reach both arms up, warrior one. Making sure that knee is in line with the ankle on that right side. Good. Next exhale, lower the arms down, interlace the fingers behind the back. We'll inhale to lengthen, draw the heart up and forward. Exhale, folding into our humble warrior. Taking whichever variation you took on the opposite side here.
Slow.
slowly start to lift up. Nice. Beautiful.
Yep.
Got it. Sir, left arm move forward. Are you start to lower down, start to make your way back onto the ground. We're gonna come onto our backs. Yes, breathe. Yes, good tip. Make sure you're not holding your breath
and you can't panic.
Trust yourself. And if you have blocks at home, this is something you can practice with against the wall as well. And then eventually, once you get used to being upside down, you're gonna start to draw the shoulders away from the blocks in this form. I'll show you what that looks like. My shoulders are resting on the blocks. Now I just threw them away. Can y'all see that difference?
Yeah.
Yep, you start drawing the shoulders away. But when you feel safe and comfortable to do so. So let's go ahead and start to make our way onto the back. Tuck the knees into the chest, rocking side to side. Give yourself some love for all the work you've put in today on your mat. Body and your physical and energetic and spiritual body. It's honoring and loving on yourself here for a moment. And as you release the mind, we're going to inhale, press the heels up towards the ceiling, pressing through the heels. Trying to get the legs as straight as you can here. So we're coming into a candlestick form, and you can stay here if you like, or you can go into a shoulder stand. I'm not going to instruct that. We've had enough inversion today, so if candlestick is where you're at, it's A-OK if you want a new shoulder stand. Have at it. Wherever you are, inhaling, pressing as much as you can through the heels. And as you exhale, start to press the toes up towards the ceiling so you can spread the toes apart. Just assisting the blood to travel back towards the heart. Inhale, press through the heels. And exhale, press through the toes. Still continuing to try to find that space between the toes. One more. And then from here, we can just rotate the ankles, making circles here in one direction. Sending that lubricating fluid back into the joints, letting go of any tightness, letting the snaps and pops release. And then rotating in the opposite direction. Stick, you're going to reach your hands up towards your feet. Good. As you slowly roll out of Halasana, you're going to lead us into this version of candlestick. We're going to go into a little bit more core before we rest. So as you inhale, we're going to slowly lower the heels down and reach the arms over the head. Extending the feet and arms in opposite directions without touching the ground. And as you exhale, bring them back in together. If you like an extra little fire there, you can even reach, crunch up, and try to touch your toes. And inhale, open it up, maybe coming back to that flower and envisioning yourself opening up your petals here. Free. arms. On your next exhale, allow the knees to lower over towards the left side of the body. Take one more spinal twist for our practice, sending your gaze towards the right fingertips or right elbow in the opposite direction of the knees. Take a deep inhale in through the nose here, feeling the breath travel into the belly, expanding into the ribs, and even down into the low back. And as you exhale, sigh it out the mouth, let it go. Inhale the knees center, and exhale to the opposite side. Shifting your gaze in the opposite direction. Filling up on life again here. Inhale deeply into the belly, allowing everything to open up and expand all the way down into the base of the spine. And when you're ready to release, side out the mouth. Inhaling back center. Maybe taking happy baby here, grabbing the outer edges of the feet and pressing the heels up towards the ceiling. Or taking any other form that you'd like to include in your practice before we go into our final rest. Maybe if you'd like to extend your spinal twist, that's good. Whatever you need. If you want to just go straight into your rest, that's an option as well. We'll take 5 more breaths here, wherever you are, whatever you're doing. Slowly make your way into Shavasana. Again, coming back to what feels natural and organic for you. Start to settle into this final resting form of your practice. Just scanning again through the body. See if there's anything else there that you can let go on a physical level, on a mental level, emotional level, energetic level. Allowing yourself to soften a little bit more with each breath, allowing the breath to become natural. Letting go of control of the breath and the body as you settle into stillness. Settle into silence. And take rest. Thank you. into your sentient existence, inviting gentle movements back into the body, maybe starting with the breath as you deepen in. Thank you.
able to share this space with all of you. Demetrius and I are happy to see you here. I'm grateful that you came, and Demetrius is also so kind to share his gifts with classes, with yoga classes for donations. So if you really, if you thoroughly felt those therapeutic sounds within your whole being, please offer anything you can, any love offering. Maybe it's a kind word, maybe it's a monetary offering. He has PayPal, Cash App, Venmo, all of those barcodes are on his wagon there. He's also on Instagram, so that you can follow him and see all the amazing things that he's doing in the community. He's also available for private bookings. He did an amazing job at Rick and Shamika's wedding back in February. It was so awesome. So if you have like any events, baby showers, weddings, whatever coming up, connect with Demetrius because he's awesome. So we have a wonderful offering coming up next month. The Zen and Kush. It's a 2-day event. It's the Spirit Bazaar.
Yes. It's going to be, the intention is bringing awareness to higher consciousness practices. So we got Lizzie Jeff. She's going to be coming to perform. She's also doing Zen and Kush on day 2. And the first day, we're going to have yoga classes in the yoga studio all day long, different breathwork sessions, meditation, Reiki, a couple different healing techniques. We got a sound bath with Truth and Demetrius as well. And what else? If anybody didn't pay for yoga class, if you don't got it, cool. If you do got it, Cash App, Elevated Yoga, or share love with somebody.
And just going back to that event, if you're an artist, creative, any kind, and you would like to collaborate and be a part of the event, there is a form on Elevated Yogi's website. If you're interested in vending or sharing whatever you would like to share, you can fill out that form and we can connect with you and hopefully
have
you be a part of all the magic that we're creating that day.
Yeah, if anybody do anything magical, whatever you call magical, like we got interested in like hula hoopers, fire dancers. If you do anything bizarre and like got a hobby and stuff like that, just sharing those things. Creative sharing the art they value is the festival, man.
And last but not least, Demetrius, would you like to share anything?
Well, I do have a community yoga class coming up this Saturday at Detroit Bloom, right outside of Grosse Pointe. They're asking for a $10 donation to help with the upkeep of the community garden. So if anybody wants to come out and hang out with me and have a yoga class out there, just let me know so I can give you directions to get there. So that's pretty much it.
And Detroit Bloom is beautiful. I've been there a couple of times. I've been to a few gatherings there. It's a beautiful community garden. I just love seeing all the community gardens that are coming up in Detroit. And Detroit Bloom is one of them. They have a beautiful pond. They have a cut flower garden. And then if you're actually interested in having a plot of land to like grow your own things, like vegetables or whatever, I mean, if you have a house, great. Like some people, if you're like living apartment style and you want to like grow something outdoors, you can connect with Detroit Bloom to exchange your time, like volunteering on their garden to have your own little plot of land and grow whatever you like. So it's a beautiful space. And they have this beautiful, what is it called? It's like, I don't want to call it a gazebo.
It's pavilion.
Pavilion, that's what it is. It's a beautiful pavilion that they built, and that's where they usually host the class. The acoustics are there, and they're nice. So just imagine that with Demetrius drums. It's awesome. So if you would like to support a community garden, that's one of the many gardens.
And also, if anybody has things that you share, if you got things, anything you want to share, it's open space. Well, it's not a competitive environment, even if you offer some of the same things. We are not each other's competition. We're just here to support each other.
For sure.
So feel free.
Yeah, anybody got anything exciting coming up that we can maybe support you with? Any shows? offerings, prayer music.
No pressure.
No pressure.
And if you remember later, you can always come up to me or Leonard and let us know, like, hey, I got this going on. We love to support you. Again, my name is Truth, and I'm She Is Truth on Instagram. So if you want to connect there, feel free. Yeah. Thank you all again for coming, and hope you enjoy the rest of your evening.
Thank you.
Thank you.